Wish I had 35 more tons. How do you imagine Shakya Muni Buddha coming from this pure land, to the space in front of you, or you manifesting spontaneously from the Dhammakaya, from the omniscient mind that pervades everything? So you might have seen some beautiful image from Shakyamuni Buddha over the years, various statues or various images. So whichever one inspired you. Sometimes it's, in India there's some kind of posters of Shakyamuni Buddha. A little bit Indian style, like an Indian Swami, you know, the robes, the top knot. Okay. So whichever image inspired that makes you, or some of the Gandhara style of statues, where they have this like a Greek kind of art, very beautiful. Whichever art style inspired the most. And try to make him as alive as possible. So Lama Yeshe used to say, whenever you imagine the Buddha is really there. But in Tantra, so then you imagine that light rays goes from the Buddha out and invites all the Buddha into the visualization. So that's to reinforce, you know, to convince us more that the Buddha is actually there. And then again you invite Buddhas to make, to bless the Buddha that you visualize. So the Buddha that you have visualized received the initiation, right? And then the Buddhas that gave the initiation absorb into the Buddha that you visualized. So all these things Lama used to say, it was to reinforce our conviction that the Buddha is really there in front of you. That's the purpose for these different visualizations. So all the various development of teaching on this earth since 2500 years, all the various forms of Buddhis and Sadhguru all came due to the kindness of Shakyamuni Buddha. So his spiritual energy was so strong that he was able to influence so many beings over 2,500 years. And that's in his spiritual tradition, still very much alive. So that's all the kindness of Shakyamuni Buddha. So then in his act appear as an arm generosity. So it symbolizes infinite love and compassion. So it's the manifest generosity, it's the manifestation of Shakyamuni Buddha's love and compassion. Then Shakyamuni Buddha's love and compassion manifests for us in the form of 35 Buddhas and 7 medicine Buddhas radiating from his heart. So out of compassion for us to cleanse a great amount of negative karma, mental affliction. Manifest as these various Buddhas. So there's a various ways to visualize them. In this visualization you have a row of blue one, row of white one, of red one, of yellow one, of green one. In other, each one has a different color, different mudra. So this various visualization comes from various lineages. So it doesn't really matter. What's important is to have the feeling of presence. See, whether one can visualize or not is not the most important. So those holy beings we offer the prayer.
Namo Shivaya. Thank you.
rest in your heart. Either you meditate, if your mind absorbs into your heart, if that's what you feel like doing now, or you imagine that the sphere of light becomes bigger and bigger, becomes the size of your body, and then becomes inseparably mixed, like water into water, so your mind becomes one with Chaitanya's mind. Then whenever you're ready, whenever you feel like, gently put your attention onto the movement of the breath. So you try to hold the breath gently, lovingly, with your full attention to this peaceful movement rising and falling of the breath. And you try to hold on to it, neither too tightly nor too loose. And then gradually, as your mind and body relaxes, you try to absorb your mind into the movement of the breath. So you try to reduce the gap, being up in your head and looking down. You try to become the breath. Gradually go into bodhicitta mode. So you are keeping whatever meditative absorption you are in. So within that, see, try to realize how much you want to be happy, how much you would like to have a still mind. See how much you would have. How much you don't want to have any problems, any pain, any mental affliction. So try to feel that in you. And then realize it's the same for everyone in this room. Like I want to have a peaceful mind and no mental affliction, so it is to everyone inside here. See, within their mind is exactly the same. Shantideva says, you know, it's just out of habit that I'm more concerned about this mind than other people's mind. I think it's exactly the same of all human beings on this planet and other planets wherever they are human beings. They also have a mind and they would love to have a peaceful, happy, gentle mind without mental affliction. Same. Likewise, all the animals, they would love to have a peaceful, happy mind without any afflictions. And all the beings in the house, they also would love to have a peaceful, happy mind without any pain and mental. All the beings in the Praetorium, or angry ghosts, who also would love to have a happy mind. And then all the asuras, the demigods, would love to have a happy mind. And then all the gods, the desire, form and formless worlds, all love to be happiness that's beyond suffering for anyone. So we're all the same. So why care only for my own happiness? Why can't I care for the happiness of everyone? Why is there this indifference in my heart? mind training text composed by Maitripa, which was one of the guru of Marpa Lotsawa and a friend of Atisha. That's very nice. I read it to you. To guide all beings who have been my parents. I will extract without exception the five poisons of each being. By means of the five poisonous affliction present in me, whatever distraction, attachment, irritation, whatever affliction you have, you make use of them. Imagine taking upon you the similar affliction of all beings onto you, and thereby freeing them from that affliction. If you have a distracted mind, say by myself being distracted, I take all the distraction of all things upon me, may they be free of it. And instead of being overly concerned by me, my distraction, my affliction, my problem, suddenly the mind changes. Actually, doesn't mind to have those afflictions or those distractions, it makes use of it to expand the mind. Whatever virtue I may possess, such as an absence of attachment, I will distribute equally to all beings of the six realms. Whatever peace of mind you have, you share with all beings. using the painful fruits of my karma, such as sickness and so on, I will extract all similar suffering of all of sentient beings. So whatever health issue you might have, imagine taking away the similar health issue of all living beings. Imagine that by myself experiencing this pain, and no one else has to experience it, and take all that pain from me. Freeing all beings of that pain by myself experiencing this pain. That doesn't mean that you don't go to the doctor and that you try to get cured. It means while you try to get cured, whenever you have the pain, sickness, you still can do this visualization, this imagination. Whatever joy and benefit I may possess, such as an absence of illness, I will distribute equally to all beings of the six realms. If I do this, what occasion is there for me, even for a single instant, to wander aimlessly in this ocean of psychic existence? Each moment is so precious. Whatever life situation we are in, we can do this practice. yet until I have attained full enlightenment. Whatever classes of the five poisons and their fruits may lie in store, I will exhaust entirely in this very lifetime. So whatever attachment, irritation, pride, jealousy, we try to overcome, try to pacify. I will extract them this very year. This very month, I will exhaust them this very day and this very instant. I will seek the means to cut even the thread of minor sufferings. O Maitri Yogi, make sure that your mind becomes trained in this way. Positive energy we have generated by reciting the name of 35 Buddhas and doing some karma binding and then reflecting on Maitri Pass, Maitri. All this virtue we offer may be the cause for our Skuti to reach enlightenment for the benefit of all living beings.